Hello friends, I welcome you all on India's largest and number one e-learning educational platform, that is Quidda. All the candidates who are joining me live, just quickly confirm your presence in the comment section and tell me whether my audio and visual quality, everything is clear. Till you are going to report me this, let me just brief you what is the ideal duration and what is the agenda or the outcome of this session. Friends, the duration of this session is going to be approximately 40 to 45 minutes, and the outcome or the agenda of this session is that we are going to have a very short series in which we are going to revise complete electrical machines. And this series is for those students who want to have a good preparation for GATE and Engineering Services Examination 2022. To all the candidates who are joining me live, just quickly confirm your presence in the comment section. You can say hi also, and you can just tell me whether my audio and visual quality, everything is clear. Everybody who is joining the session live or recorded, just quickly follow the LSS method. Just like the session, share this session, and subscribe to the GRADeUp YouTube channel so that more and more people are going to join us, and you will get all the class notifications in time. Everybody who is watching me live, just quickly confirm your presence and let us move on to the next part of our discussion. Some of you may be joining me for the first time, so there is a brief introduction about myself. My name is Ashutosh Saxena, 10 plus years of teaching experience, M.Tech from IIT BHU in 2010, written couple of books on engineering ethics and power system. My areas of expertise are power system, electrical machines, electromagnetic field theory, material science, and obviously engineering ethics. Hi Mr. Arun, how are you? Welcome to the session. Some of you may be preparing for GATE 2022 examination seriously. So GRADeUp is bringing to you the champion study plan, which is a 120 days free crash course. The classes have already started. If you have missed these classes, you can attend these classes. They are available on the GRADeUp app and the GRADeUp YouTube channel, and these classes are going to help you in the right direction. Yes, hi Arun, how are you? If you want to join a structured regular course for BARC examination, you can join boost-up course for electrical, electronics and mechanical students. The enrollments have already started. These are the important highlights, and if you have any confusion, you can contact our counselors and they are going to help you in the right direction. If you are going to join the GRADeUp Super subscription, these are the important courses that you can access: Vision 2022 English, Vision 2022 Hindi, and Vision 2023 Hindi and English courses. All these courses are quite comprehensive and effective for your preparation. So if you have any confusion, any query, you can contact this number and you will be assisted positively. These are the panel of faculties in the electrical department who are going to mentor you in the next coming preparation cycle. All the faculties are highly experienced and expertise in their respective field. So if you are coming to GRADeUp, my friend, you are in safe hands. Money saying, yes, definitely Mani, we'll be having sessions for ethics also and current affairs, general awareness also. Definitely, definitely Mani, thank you so much. So let us start with the questions. We'll be having some couple of questions, and with the help of these questions, we'll try to understand some of the basic concepts which will help you in understanding the most interesting yet most confused subject, that is electrical machines. So let me start with the first question. Everybody, just focus. The counter EMF of a shunt motor is given. The field resistance is 160 ohm. Field current is given. The line current is given. And he is asking armature resistance. This type of question does not require brain. It just requires memory. Why? You just draw the circuit. Shunt motor, very beautiful shunt motor. These are the brushes, armature resistance, because it is shunt motor, so field is going to be connected in shunt. And because it is a motor, so you must give some DC supply so that this motor can run. So this is going to be your supply voltage. Yes, this is going to be counter EMF or back EMF. because this is a motor, so this is going to take current from the supply. So this is going to be the line current. This line current is going to be divided into the armature current of this shunt motor and the shunt field current. This is your shunt field resistance and this is your armature resistance. He is simply asking you, what is the value of this armature resistance? Now, if you know the terminal voltage and if you know the back EMF and if you know the armature current, very easily you can write the KVL equation. V is going to be back EMF plus IARA. From here you can find the armature resistance as V minus back EMF or counter EMF divided by IA. Yes or no? Pranam, Shubhadeep, beta, Ashirwad. Okay. Now see, he is saying counter EMF is 227 volts. So back EMF, you know, back EMF is given. How much? 227 volts. What is armature current? Can you tell me what is armature current? Armature current, how you are going to find? Line current is given. Shunt field current you can find. So very easily you can find the armature current. But for that purpose you require what is the terminal voltage. But you don't have any data directly to find the terminal voltage. So what you are going to do? This terminal voltage is coming across this shunt field. It means, can I write this as ISH multiplied by RSH? Yes. ISH is given 1.5 ampere multiplied by RSH 160 ohms. So all the candidates who have done speed maths classes in their childhood, they can simply answer this. What is the answer you are getting for the supply voltage? Tell me faster. Yes. ₹240. Yes. Speed math children. Ranjit Mahal. Namaste. Namaste beta. How are you? Welcome to the session. 240 volts you are getting. Now listen very carefully. This current, you know, this current he is giving as 1.5 ampere. And this is the line current. Line current is given as 39.5 amperes. So this is going to be 39.5 amperes. So this current minus this current, you will get this current. So this is going to be 38 amperes. Very easily you can find. So now you have all the values. You have the terminal voltage of the supply, 240 volts. Back EMF is given 227 volts. Armature current you can put and you can find what is the armature resistance. Everybody just tell me in the comment section, are you able to follow this? Everybody just quickly confirm, are you able to follow this? I think very easy question. Good evening Utkarsh, how are you? Welcome to the session. Let us see the next question. Now this is one of the most classical and beautiful question. He is giving lot more details in the question. And let me tell you one thing, electrical machines and power system, the question is going to be big, but the answer is going to be small. So don't fear the length of the question. If you have the concepts, don't fear the length of the question. He is giving you some important details. Let us read them. He is saying there is a 4-pole DC machine which is having 100 armature conductors. EMF induced in each armature conductor is 2 volts when the speed is 1000 rpm. Yes. If somebody asks you what is your name and from where you belong, then you will say, my name is this, I belong to this and that. So whenever he is introducing a machine in the question, he has to give some of these specifications as per the requirement. The maximum allowed current in each armature conductor without overheating is 10 ampere and the resistance of each conductor is 0.01 ohms. Now he is asking the ratio of armature copper losses for lap and wave winding. So basically there are two cases. One case he is saying there is a lap winding. When you have the lap winding, the number of parallel paths are equal to number of poles. It is a 4-pole DC machine, so number of parallel paths are going to be 4. So the situation is something like this. There are 4 parallel paths. This is how your armature is going to look like. Yes. Now he is saying in each parallel path, without overheating, the armature conductor can handle 10 ampere. Now this is one armature conductor, this is one armature conductor, this is one armature conductor. What is the maximum allowed current? 10 ampere. All the branches maximum allowed current is 10 ampere, 10 ampere, 10 ampere. So what is the possible armature current? 40 amperes in case of lap winding. Very easily you can do it. Now let us come to the wave winding. Wave winding says irrespective of the number of poles, the number of parallel paths are going to be 2. Yes or no? So how your armature is going to look like for a wave wind, wave wound machine? It is going to have 2 parallel paths, something like that. Something like that. Yes or no? Now he is saying possible current is 10 ampere. Possible current is 10 ampere. So what is the possible armature current? 20 ampere. He is asking you the ratio of Utkarsh. I am taking classes everywhere on Grader platforms, whether it is paid courses, whether it is app or whether it is YouTube. And if you want to get all the class notifications in time, you can join my personal Telegram channel that is given by GradeUp, that I will tell you in the end part of this session. So stay with me for this session, and in the last part of this session I will be giving you the detail. You join that Telegram channel and you will be getting all the important informations. Now he is asking the ratio of armature copper losses. What is armature copper losses? IA square RA. So we have found the armature current for the lap wound and the wave wound machine. So we have to find the armature resistance. How we are finding armature resistance? Let us try to understand. This is your DC machine. This is your DC machine. Okay. And your DC machine is going to look something like this. Something like this. Something like this. Have a little bit of patience if you want to understand the concept. Okay. So this is going to be how your machine is going to look like from inside. Now this small resistance R and this small EMF E is nothing but a conductor. This is just a conductor in your armature winding. Some EMF is induced in that armature conductor, which is represented by small E, and there is some resistance present in this armature conductor that we are defining as a small R. So basically we have to find the armature resistance. How we are finding? The first thing I am going to find is, what is the total resistance of one parallel path? Yes or no? What is the total resistance of one parallel path? Definitely you can give me all your doubts on that Telegram channel and I will try my level best to answer that. So what is going to be the resistance of one parallel path? I have to find the number of conductors present in one parallel path, and that I have to multiply with this small r. So resistance of one parallel path, this is going to be total number of conductors divided by number of parallel paths. This will give me the number of conductors in one parallel path multiplied by a small r. This is the resistance of one parallel path of the armature circuit. How many such parallel paths are there? 1, 2 up to A. So what is going to be armature resistance, my friend? This is going to be 1 upon A multiplied by the resistance of one parallel path, that is Z into R divided by A. So this is going to be RZ upon A square. Is it clear for everybody? Now if you see, whether it is a lap bound machine or whether it is a wave bound machine, this small r value and capital Z value is not going to change, because the resistance of one conductor
And the total number of conductor is not going to change for lap and wave bound. So this is going to be a constant. So can I say that armature resistance is directly proportional to the inverse of a square of the number of parallel paths? Utkarsh beta, bacche ki jaan loge kya? Sab milega bhai tumko telegram pe. You will get everything on that telegram channel. But whatever you want to do, first requirement is that you have patience. The exam that you are going to prepare, GATE and engineering services examination, these are long-term goals. These are not immediate goals that tomorrow morning, okay, I have to run 10 kilometers, you can run. No. Every day you have to run 2 kilometers. You must have patience. Are you getting that? So can I write RA lap, RA wave? Yes. This is going to be A wave divided by A lap, and this is going to be whole square. What is the number of parallel path in wave bound machine? 2. What is the number of parallel path in lap bound machine? A is equal to P, P is equal to 4. So this is 4, and do the square. 2 ekam 2, 2 2 3 4, and this is 1 upon 4. Now if you find the ratio of armature copper losses, IA lap square RA lap divided by IA square wave multiplied by RA wave, this is going to be how much? What is the ratio of IA lap? IA lap is 40, so 40 square. IA wave is 20, so 20 square. And what is the ratio of armature resistance for the lap and wave winding? 1/4. So this is 1/4. Again, speed maths children, koi mil gaya jadu. 0 0 0 0, do duni char, 4 4 goes off and you get 1:1. What is the final answer you are getting? B option. Now this is normal life, and if you want to see the mentor's zindagi, okay, mentor's life. What is mentor's life? Let me just show you. You know that toffee, na? That toffee candy, mentor's. I am giving you a black box. This is a black box. There are some resistances. I don't know what is the connection inside this black box. I am just giving you this black box. Are you getting that? You are giving some voltage. You are giving some voltage. You are getting some current. You tell me, whatever combination is going to be there inside this black box for these resistances, can you change the power? No. The power will remain constant. If you increase the voltage, the current will reduce. If you increase the current, the voltage will reduce. It means, if power is going to remain same, it means the power loss is also going to remain same. And this is mentor's life. You don't need to solve this question. This type of question, if he's saying armature copper loss, this, lap bound, wave bound machine, final answer 1:1. Close the chapter. Everybody just tell me in the comment section, are you getting this or not? And can you say hi? Can you say hi? Yes. Next. Now I can say this is one of the most classical question of DC machine. If you understand this question, your life will become gaga. You know what is gaga? When you jump from your seat, that process is called gaga. You will go gaga. You will jump from your chair when you understand this concept. He is saying there is a 4-pole lap bound generator which is running at 900 rpm. Self inductance is this much. Armature current is this much. Number of commutator segment this much. Width of the brush this much. And the reactance voltage will be, what is reactance voltage? reactance voltage we are defining as L di by dt. L is the self inductance. What is di? 2ic. What is 2ic? What is commutation? What is commutation, Baba? Can you tell me what is commutation, Baba? This is plus IC. This is minus IC. In between this is commutation period. If you are going for a big examination and somebody is asking what is commutation, then I am giving you the words shortest possible definition of commutation. The complete reversal of current in the commutating coil is commutation. You want to see that? How many candidates want to see this commutation process just right now in this class? Say yes if you are interested, and if you know that, then we can simply solve this boring question. If you want to see life from your eyes, how the current is changing the direction, do you want to see that? Everybody, tell me in the comment section. Suppose this is your DC machine. This is a two pole DC machine. These are your brushes. Very beautiful brushes. Okay. Very handsome brushes. This is your north pole. This is your south pole. How you are getting north pole and south pole? Electromagnets. Apply the right hand rule. North pole means flux is going from core to the air. This is core, and this is air gap. Whenever flux goes from core to the air gap, this is north pole. So what is the direction? Right hand thumb rule. Fingers moving in the direction of current, thumb is going to give you the direction of flux. So here it is going to be dot, here it is going to be cross. South pole, the flux is going from air gap to the core. When flux is going, it is south pole. Again, apply the right hand thumb rule. Fingers moving in the direction of current, thumb in the direction of flux. So this is dot again, and this is cross again. Now there will be some armature conductors in the armature slots like this. This is the beauty of a commutator machine. What is that beauty? Please try to understand. Whatever I'm saying, you will say with me, even if I'm not able to listen to that, you will say in your mind whatever I'm going to say. Next thing. All the conductors under the north pole cross all the time. If this is the generator rotational direction, suppose we are talking about generator, all the conductors which are under the north pole, they are going to have cross. All the conductors which are under the south pole, they are going to have dot. Are you getting this? Everybody tell me in the comment section. If you don't know why this polarity is there, that also I can explain to you. How you are going to find it? Let me just explain. Otherwise, it will be... Suppose generator is moving in this direction, it means this part of the conductor, what is the torque direction? This part of the conductor, what is the torque direction? Like this. For any generator, if you want to find the direction of induced EMF current, what you are going to apply? Fleming's right hand rule. For the DC motor, if you want to know the direction of rotation force or the torque, What is the rule you are going to apply? Fleming's left hand rule. Just right hand and left hand difference is there. Just naming is same. Index finger in the direction of flux. Utkarsh is saying voice break ho rahi hai. Is there any voice issue? Just everybody tell me in the comment section about my audio and visual quality. Everybody just tell me in the comment section about my audio and visual quality. Now it is okay. Is still voice is breaking or is it okay now? Now it is okay. Yes, it is okay. Again, voice is breaking. Let me just listen to my. The
voice.
Okay. Voice is perfect now.
Yes, it is okay. Again, voice is breaking.
See, listen. If you want to learn such a subject like electrical machines free of cost, at least buy a good mobile, good earphone. Yes or no? Anyways, I am joking. Do not take it seriously. I was saying that for any generator, if you want to know the direction of induced EMF and current, you have to apply the Fleming's right hand rule. What is Fleming's right hand rule? Index finger in the direction of flux. Index finger in the direction of flux. Thumb in the direction of torque, force or the motion. And central finger or middle finger in the direction of induced EMF or current. So I am going to apply this Fleming's right hand rule. What is the flux? North to south, index finger. What is the direction of force or movement? Thumb. Central finger, the direction of induced EMF or current into the plane of the screen. So it is cross, 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 cross. All the time, all the conductors under the influence of North Pole, they are going to have cross, 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 cross polarity. And under the influence of South Pole, all the conductors, all the time, they are going to have dot, dot, dot polarity. Is it clear? Now. This conductor, I am saying conductor 1 or conductor 1 position. This is conductor 2 position. Because this armature is rotating, after one commutation period, this conductor is going to reach from position number 1 to position number 2. One side of the brush to the other side of the brush. In this time period, the current is having a complete reversal. In this time period, current is having a complete reversal. This process of complete reversal of current in the commutating coil within the commutation period, we are defining as commutation. Is it clear for everybody? Now, what is happening? You will say, sir, why you are saying all this? I am saying all this because no machine on this earth can rotate if there is a relative motion between the two fluxes, stator flux and rotor flux. What is the stator flux? Stator flux is from north to south. This is the main field flux. Now, because your armature conductor polarity is fixed because of commutator and the brush action, your armature flux is always perpendicular and in this direction. The load angle is always 90 degree for a DC machine. This is the load angle. This is the basic concept of rotating machine, that there should be no relative motion between the stator flux and the rotor flux. You will say, sir, why? The reason of why is, if you want to talk to me and you are running and you are saying, sir, what is armature reaction? And you just go, can I answer that? No. There should be no relative motion. Because if there is any relative motion, there can be no interaction torque, and interaction torque is only present when both are stationary with respect to each other, and you will get interaction torque. My friend, this interaction torque is nothing but the electromagnetic torque developed in the machine, and this electromagnetic torque developed in the machine is responsible for the generation of electrical energy or the voltage and current output at the terminal. Are you getting this? Everybody tell me in the comment section, are you able to follow this? So this is the complete story. So he is asking reactance voltage. So this is L2IC upon, this is the commutation period. Plus IC to minus IC, what is the total change? Total change is 2IC. Total change is 2IC. Is it clear? What is IC? What is IC? Let us try to understand what is IC. IC is the current in each parallel path. So IA divided by A. What is IA? 108. What is number of parallel paths? 4 pole lap bound. A is equal to P. 4. 27 amperes. You know what is the IC value. You know what is the L value. L value is given here. The only thing which you don't know is the commutation period. And this is the major crux of this problem. This is the major crux of this problem. How to find the commutation period? What is the speed? What is the speed? The speed in the problem is given as 900 RPM. 900 RPM. What is the meaning of 900 RPM? 900 RPM means in 1 minute, there will be 900 revolutions. So what is the time for one revolution? This is 1 upon 900 minutes. If you want to write it in second, multiply by 60. This much seconds you will take to have one revolution. Now, my friend, suppose you are standing here and you are observing the rotation of this armature. You tell me in one complete cycle how many commutator segments you are going to see. In one complete revolution, how many commutator segments you are going to see? All the commutator segments you are going to see in one complete cycle? Yes or no? Can you say yes or no in the comment section? In one complete revolution, how many commutator segments you are going to see? All the commutator segments. How many commutator segments? 55. So one revolution this time, how many segments you are crossing? 55. 60 divided by 900 seconds. What is the time of crossing one segment? What is the time of crossing one segment? 60 upon 900 multiplied by 55. And what is the commutation period? When you cross the brush width. When you cross the brush width. Utkarsh, see, if you have just started, you first attend the theory part. Okay, then you will be ready for the problems. Everything we can't explain in one problem, otherwise the whole time we'll be taking just one problem. So total segments 55 and the width of the brush is 1.74. So I have to find the time period for 1.74 commutator segment. So this is going to be 60 divided by 900 divided by 55 multiplied by 1.74. This is your commutation period. Is it clear, everybody? Are you able to follow this? How you are using this speed concept to find the commutation period? This is the major crux of this problem. This is the major crux of this problem. It is a 45-minute class. We started at 10:30. So 11:15 we'll be closing. 11:15 we'll be closing. Just 10 minutes more. What is the answer you will be getting? Now you just do the calculation part. I think you must be getting B as the correct option. Just check it. Go to the next question. Now very beautiful question. Very beautiful question. Compensating winding. Let me take the example of a 4-pole machine. Let me take the example of 4-pole machine. Suppose this is the 4-pole machine. Where you are placing your compensating winding? In the slots made in the pole shoe. So there will be compensating winding. Where will be your armature conductor? Something like this. These are the slots in which you are going to place your armature conductors. What is the purpose of compensating winding? Compensating winding. Purpose is to neutralize cross magnetizing effect of the armature reaction under the polar region, under the poles. Is it clear? Are you able to follow this? This is why we require compensating winding. So basically what we are doing, ampere turns of the compensating winding are going to be neutralizing the ampere turns of the armature winding per pole. If you see the ampere turns of the armature winding for a DC machine is a closed winding like this. So if you find it for one pole, it is going to be from here to here. What is this? This is pole pitch. What is this? This is pole arc. It means what you are finding as ampere turns of the armature winding per pole, that you are finding for one pole pitch, but the compensating winding is only present in the pole arc. It means whatever you are finding as ampere turns of the armature winding per pole, you have to multiply it by pole arc divided by pole pitch. That's it. Now you just need to write. Actually the daily class timing is at 12 in the afternoon. See, if you see the Grade Up YouTube, there is a playlist. Okay, you can find number of sessions available for electrical machines basics. You can also go to the Grade Up app. Every day lot of lectures are available on Grade Up app that you can watch and you can enrich your preparation. I'm sorry, Utkarsh, if I hurt you. My intention was not like that. Okay. You just join my personal Telegram channel. I will tell you everything. Don't worry. Or you can contact the backend team member. How we are writing ampere turns of the compensating winding? Ampere turns means number of turn multiplied by current in each turn. What is the current in each turn? Compensating winding. Remember, compensating winding is connected in series with the armature winding. So what is the current? IA. Number of turns in the compensating winding, total number of conductors divided by 2. Why? Because one turn requires 2 conductors. These are the conductors. This is conductor. This is conductor. This is overhang portion. Bekar ka. Useless. This is conductor. This is conductor. How many conductors require to make one turn? 2. Total number of conductors divided by 2. Number of turns. Pole arc upon pole pitch is given. How much? 0.7. What is ampere turns of the armature winding per pole? Ampere turns of the armature winding per pole. Ampere turns of the armature winding means number of turns. How many number of turns? Z divided by 2, total number of conductors in the armature, divided by 2, you will get the number of turns. Current in each turn. What is the meaning of current in each turn? This is a turn. What is the current in each turn? IC. What is IC? Current in one parallel path. That is IA upon A. So this is going to be IA upon A multiplied by number of turns. But it is ampere turns of the armature winding per pole. So divided by P. So this is IAZ upon 2AP. This you should always remember. So this is IAZ upon 2AP. So it is going to be cancelled. IA, IA cancelled. 2, 2 cancelled. Now you can find ZCW. Very close, you will get 6. Because number of conductors cannot be in fraction, so it is going to be 6. Is it clear for everybody? Is it clear for everybody? Tell me yes or no in the comment section. Are you able to follow this? Is it clear? So this is all from my side for today. We are running short of time. And you can solve rest of the questions as your homework. Rest of the questions you can solve as your homework. And if you are not able to solve it, tomorrow we are going to take care of that. Tomorrow we are going to take care of that. Okay, so do all these problems. And if you want the complete PPT or the PDF, then you can join my personal Telegram channel. This is my personal Telegram channel on GridUp. How you are going to join this Telegram channel? That is very, very important. Just download the Telegram app on your app or the laptop. Search the channel name Electrical by Ashutosh Saxena. And the moment you see my beautiful photograph, you join this Telegram channel. You can ask your doubts. You can get the class notifications for my classes. You will be getting all the PPTs, PDFs, contents, books, whatever help you require that is in my capacity. I will try to answer your doubts. Okay. GridUp Super subscription, just one subscription which gives you access to all the structured live courses and the green card. For any further assistance, you can contact this number and you will be assisted positively. All these things you will be getting under the GridUp Super subscription. So this is all from my side, friends. The daily class timing is 12 p.m. in the afternoon only on GridUp Gate YouTube channel. The lectures are delivered by several faculties. I am not the only one. I have shown you the number of faculties in electrical department. Similarly, in other departments also, we have number of faculties. Thank you so much, friends, for joining me live in the discussion. Take care of yourself. Get up ke saath sahi prep hai to life set hai. Thank you so much. Good night. Take care. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.